Más de 25 bailarines de distintas nacionalidades estarán en el escenario para mostrar lo mejor del repertorio de sus compañías en la Gala Internacional de Ballet.
Los invitamos a todos a vernos desde el 11 al 13 de agosto en el Teatro Municipal de Las Condes.
Mi meta es que el ballet pueda ser visto y apreciado y disfrutado por toda la familia, con artistas de categoría mundial.
Me impresionó mucho la gala que tú hiciste acá en Santiago, con tus bailarines, con los bailarines invitados. Me impresionó cómo escogiste el programa, que había cosas diferentes, que no era una gala normal.
Fue una gala donde había una línea tradicional y también contemporánea, donde vinieron artistas de distintas partes del mundo y también artistas nacionales del Ballet de Santiago.
La idea de la gala nace por la conexión con las redes sociales y con lo que está pasando en el mundo, con este boom de las galas en las capitales y no capitales, donde cada ciudad intenta hacerse presente en base a esto, como una especie de juego olímpico, donde también surgen nuevos bailarines productores.
Fue una experiencia bien intensa porque llegamos a Chile una semana antes del estreno y dentro de esta semana tuvimos que aprender coreografías, como la apertura y la coda final. Tuvimos que aprender todo en una semana. Sí, yo creo que durante esta semana intensa, claro, viviendo prácticamente 24 horas juntos, claro, se construyó lazos, amistad.
I thought the gala was done really well. It was really nice to see so many great dancers from all around the world come together and share their gifts and dance beautifully for three nights. And it was just really nice to be a part of that.
It was an incredible experience dancing with all those high-level dancers and famous dancers from around the world. Performing in that theater was incredible.
Well, I do have to say that going to Santiago, Chile for the International Ballet Gala was my most favorite tour I've ever done with State Street Ballet. It was just such a wonderful city, first of all. People were so warm and friendly. The theater was amazing, and to share that stage with so many other beautiful dancers, wonderful artists, amazing choreography, it just felt very unifying and very special. So it was one of my most favorite things I've ever done, especially with State Street Ballet.
Esa gala que hicimos acá en Chile es una gala muy distinta porque no se vio solamente el ballet clásico.
Uno de mis mayores desafíos fue brindar a la audiencia diversidad. En primer caso, diversidad coreográfica, con estrenos en Sudamérica y en Chile. En el caso de After the Rain de Christopher Weldon desde Londres, Ave María de Complexion Ballet desde Nueva York, que no solo se vean parejas en el escenario, sino que también se puede apreciar una compañía desde California, el State Street Ballet con Common Ground y Conversion, que puedan apreciar una comedia distendida dentro de la serie Una Gala con el ícono en la comedia del ballet que se llama Trocadero, que puedan también ver una pequeña pieza de Broadway por un artista de Broadway, en el caso de Georgina del New York City Ballet.
The pleasure of meeting so many dancers from so many different countries. I myself, I am from Switzerland, so I met dancers from all over the world, and it was such a wonderful experience all over, meeting not in the theater but also people on the street. The Chilean are so warm, welcoming. The people in the theater were so nice, from the people at the reception in the theater, everybody, the director. It was really, really awesome. I would do it again anytime if we are invited back.
Super.
The program itself was so diverse that, and I'm kind of aware that the people of Chile and Santiago are used to more classical work, so I didn't know how they were going to respond to contemporary dance, but they seem to be very pleased and enjoy themselves.
So Ave Maria is probably one of the oldest works that I've done. It actually comes from a larger work called The Grapes of Wrath. And I did this ballet in 1995, so it's a very old piece. But it's like a signature pas de deux for me, and many companies do it, and it's a difficult piece, especially for the girl. But many of the people who have done it, they work so hard on it, and it's very intricate, but the music is so beautiful, and the audience always responds to the piece in a very loving way. People love Ave Maria.
The audience reaction is great. I mean, they loved the show, from what I could tell. You know, at the end of the show, everybody was screaming and clapping for us. And, I mean, it was great.
La verdad es que fue muy grato ver a artistas de clase mundial y también que el público pudiera acceder a esto a precios, digamos, muy al alcance.
La audiencia chilena es muy crítica. O sea, el chileno cuando va al teatro, él sabe lo que va y espera un determinado nivel. Entonces, para no solamente para mí, pero para todos estos bailarines que hicieron parte, recibir estos aplausos, estos bravos, fue maravilloso, muy, muy, muy especial.
They really know what dance is, and they really know about arts. They so I was also surprised about that, and they know what quality is, quality performance is, and obviously they really like the show, they really like the gala.
The reaction of the audience I thought was quite fantastic, and I was nervous because we brought 10 dancers from State Street Ballet, and we did ballet repertoire where we had 10 dancers on stage, rather. And we had couples from, you know, Royal Ballet and New York City Ballet, and famous dancers. So I was a little nervous about these different levels, but the way it was constructed and the way you organized the project worked very well.
Definitely, if there is something I wanted to highlight, I would definitely say that just seeing the mountains in Chile, and the way that the city is set up was something really mind-blowing for me. And to be in that kind of city and to have the mountains in the view is just it was a great experience.
Also, bringing the culture to the students and getting to have that outreach program was really a great experience.
San Francisco del Alba is cool.
Yeah, that was great. The kids were so enthusiastic, and I really feel that we touch them a little bit because they don't get to see something like that. Exactly.
And they give you a huge hug.
They did. They loved us there.
Latin American hugs. Yeah.
They loved us. And we loved them back because of all the effort that they gave, and they didn't even speak English. You know, we didn't speak Spanish. They didn't speak English. And between the language barrier, that shows that dance can be, you know, an international language, and that anybody can participate no matter who you are. So that was great. Bye guys. Thanks again for having us in Chile.
Fun to go to that school and perform for them, and they loved it. And we had a great question and answer session afterward that probably lasted for about 30 minutes. And they were just enthralled to learn everything about dance.
It was really special to go into the elementary school and do the outreach for the kids that had never seen dance before. It's always a bit of a challenge to dance not on stage, but doing that and getting them so excited and teaching them the choreography and giving them the opportunity to stand up and try it themselves was really just amazing.
It's kind of unbelievable. You had all these language barriers, but then you see these stories being told through dance, and they're so universal. Dance is the same language no matter where you're at, and I think that's a really, really important thing to show. Everybody's telling these same stories, and you still understand them no matter what language you're speaking.
Un desafío visual fue construir escenografías digitales originales, traer la ambientación de una gran producción clásica a la velocidad de un programa mixto, una gala. Trabajamos el equilibrio de luz entre visuales y escenario con transiciones y movimientos sutiles, intentando no distraer el enfoque. principal que solo bailarín.
And this gala really spoke to the heart of what makes us all human. You know, we may be different colors from different countries, speaking different languages, but in our hearts and what we want for our families and our life and our joy and our love is all common. And through the arts, we find these messages.
Para el teatro, esta fue su primera gala que hace de ballet. Si bien habíamos tenido ballet, pero nunca habíamos hecho una gala con personas desde afuera, lo cual nos implicó invertir en piso, de rebote y hacer concesiones que con otras obras no hacemos. Pero el resultado fue un resultado óptimo, fue un muy bonito espectáculo.
It was probably one of the best theaters I've ever been in. The stage was massive and wonderful, and it was super bouncy, and it wasn't hard at all. And the seating I felt like was beautiful. I sat and watched a little bit of dress rehearsal, and I could feel that being an audience member in there would be a really amazing thing.
You could tell that the people there really cared about what they were doing and cared about making sure that it was the best experience for everybody.
The theater was beautiful, very modern. Not a huge house, so it was very nice and intimate and kind of top of the like state of the art. Everything was very easy and we were very well taken care of, and it's a beautiful theater.
I would definitely recommend doing this project again. I think globally it's a great example of what we need now to foster connection through different countries and for the arts, and it really brought people together.
Thank you. I'd like to thank Casey. I'd like to thank the theater and Los Andes and all the staff for providing this opportunity for all of us, because it was a wonderful experience.
Lo que hiciste en el principio para la apertura y después en el final, y encuentro que es algo que tú tienes que continuar haciendo. Y yo siempre estaré en cuanto esté acá en Santiago, en el ballet de acá del Teatro Municipal. Yo te ayudaré en lo que puedo. Entonces te felicito y a todo tu grupo y a todos los bailarines que aquí estuvieron, que fueron todos muy lindos, y espero ver el próximo. Chao.